Well, hello there and welcome to the 29th Winter Universiade. We're at the Sopka Cluster, Krasnoyarsk 2019. Well, it's been such an entertaining qualification contest earlier on in the day for the men's and ladies halfpipe competition. But as some wonderful shots look over this great city, we are in for a halfpipe party, that's for sure. Well, the schedule is the ladies first, and then it's time for the men. Two runs to impress the judges. Best score counts, winner takes all. It was quite flat light here in Sopka this afternoon, but now it's clear sky, the visibility is perfect. The pipe is massive as well. Well, the half pipe is almost 200 meters long. There'll be four or five hits per rider, and they will be looking to impress the judges. The judges are looking for deal. Remember the deal: difficulty, execution, amplitude, and landing. The more difficult the trick, the higher you'll score. The more fluid it is, the better your score is going to be as well. The more amplitude, also key. How high can the riders get out of the pipe, and the landing as well has to be clean. Remember the deal between us here and you at home. One last thing they're looking for is variation. Clementina Kowodziej from Poland will get us underway. Sixth in qualification earlier on with a score of 51.75. She's looking to drop in the goofy rider. Ninth in this competition in Spain 4 years ago. Starts with the straight air, trying to hold onto the board for as long as possible to impress the judges. And again, another straight air. There's the first turn, very nice as well. It's a 360. And again, getting all the way around with the three. So variation of tricks is key. But what's going to score high here this evening is amplitude out of the pipe. Can they keep the speed and get high? That's much better. Another straight air. But height is going to be key, and it's going to be interesting to see how the judges reward our first contestant here this evening. Tina Kowodziej, 17th last year, the World Cup in Laxey, Switzerland, which is a massive event in snowboarding. Top 20 finishes there. Top notch. Some of these shots, impressive as well. Really working that board around. Highlights. 53.75 for Clementina Kowodziej. Another German at the top of the pipe, Sarah Hart, actually from the University of Innsbruck, to drop in. Was fourth highest qualifier. The one who showed the judges that she's got some style about her. Score of 60.50. She's got good speed coming into the pipe as well. Goes straight for that straight air, holding onto the grab again for as long as possible, showing the judges that she's got a little bit of style about what she does. There is the first 360. Second one as well, but losing the speed is going to be problematic on the score. It's important for riders styling it out as well, Sarah Hart. It's important to really take off out the pipe and then land as high up the pipe as possible as well. Carries more speed through the flat bottom into the transition for the next jump. Speaking to the judges beforehand, looking for big amplitude. Who can get out the pipe will score. 45-75 for Hearts. Chartu grew two Chinese riders in a row. Set this place alight after the first run. 81.25. Really did impress the judges. It was good enough for second place. And this athlete spins. Going for the straight air to start with, trying to gain some speed. Laptop started spinning already, spun both ways with the backside spin that time. This is going to impress the judges massively. Three 60s, a couple of fives in there as well. Doesn't look too happy. We've still got the winner of the qualification from Japan, Kurumi Hime, to go next. Span both ways. Time spinning on the back side. 540. Where's this one going to stand? Is it good enough for top place? Will China have gold and silver medal position? Neng Kui holds that top spot at the moment. The judges are taking their time on this one to make sure that everything sits in order. Chartong Wu, second place, 70.50. Potentially wasn't as big as the previous run by Len Crew. Kurumi MI from Japan. Two massive runs. First out. Good amplitude was something that the judges looked for and something that they ranked high. A back five, a front five, a back five again. And a front seven as well. She goes huge. 5:40 second time around. And every single hit, she's trying to get maximum height out of this pipe. Absolutely massive from our leader from qualification, Kurumi Hime, who's having a stomping run. We've seen huge hits already, but maybe Japanese rider saved her best for the finals. Front side, back side spins, grabs that last hit for days. This is going to score high. If the clubhouse leader is 73.75, this one could go through the roof. Biggest amplitude for sure. Variation of tricks, yes. It's down to the judges. High fives all round. Coaching staff more than happy. Just losing the grab a little bit early on that shot. Really styling it out throughout as well. New leader. Yes, we have 89.25. Kurumi Hime from Japan is the leader. Podium has already been decided. In what order? We have no idea. Len Qiu going for China. Great run, first out. Third qualification with a 73.75. It's a massive, massive improvement needed to get to Kurumi Hime at the top of the podium. But she's got to go for it. She's got nothing to lose. And she goes so high with the opening air, but she needs to keep it up. Crippler followed by a straight air, and then she goes again. Similar trick to the first one. attempt. He just tries to style it out, but a couple of loose landings may have cost her already in her pursuit of gold. But she's really putting on a show for the judges. Thank you. Already an Olympian 16th place. Pyeongchang showed some good style, so showed some variation, frontside, backsides. Spins both ways. Whether it will be an improvement on the 75.5. Oh, who knows? Upgrade needed. The challenge for gold. Shatong Wu still to go.
Thank you.
What do the judges say? 83.50. That's humongous. Women's half pipe. There's the final results. Kurumi MI takes the gold. Kui silver, Shatong Wu bronze. Great performances from all of our finalists. So it's time for the men's finals of the halfpipe competition. First run, Axel Thelen,
okay, man. You
from Finland, Helsinki University, and he's stylish. And there's something we've learned throughout the first run is that he has heaps of style about what he does. We've seen a backside air, frontside 7, cab 7, frontside 9 as well from him. But he's going to need to bring big spins. There's one. But it's a combination. Can you stay consistent throughout the pipe? That's absolutely massive. And this is what the judges are awarding. Stylish, big spins. We could have a new leader again. He's going so big. Finland flying. Not as many hits as some of the previous riders, but that doesn't really matter when you're sending it that high. Forties in there. Sevens as well. The judges, it's down to them. The five in the hatch, 82.50. That's better than qualification. It's a great score. The rest are under pressure now.
Thank you.
Max Klaikos.
Hi there, Max here.
From Slovenia, University of Maribor. Second run of this final for the big hitter. Again, another World Cup rider. He's had a second in Davos, Switzerland. So he knows what it's like to make podiums at this level. But can he is the question. He didn't land his first run. He just got 12.25, but he's looking like he's going big. The backside spin early on, followed by the frontside spin as well. The backside 7. Huge stuff, and he's got to go bigger if he wants to make the podium. Grippler as well. And then he styles it out, but he's got one more hit. No, he hasn't. He's come off a little early. Happy to have landed a run, of course. After not landing the first, he's put one down. The relief is in, and he's showing the crowd and the judges what he's about.
Dave, here, this.
Мы знаем, что Макс катается здесь не особо за медали, но за, во-первых, тот свой шлем, на котором написал что-то, что уже увидел почти весь мир, друзья. Поддерживаем
Great shots. Top run. Is it good enough? It's good enough for four. By one. Great work from Max Klaikos, but it's just outside the podium. So unlucky. Alexei Magulov. One of four riders to go. Magulov currently sits in the bronze medal position for Russia. 73.50 is his score. Nothing to lose it. He has to go for broke. Can he get into the 80s? We'll have to see. It goes so high. The amplitude is there. As we've said the whole way through, this is exactly what the judges are awarding. Big spins, varied tricks, and massive air. Cripplers galore. Then he tries the flat spin off the final hit. Maybe that's not an improvement. He's gone huge though. So maybe there is an improvement. This sport is crazy. The judges might love the fact that he just went for everything. But the execution and the landing is a little bit off. Going for style early on. Just has to force the board round a couple of times. Will he better his own score? That's the question. Crowd don't think so. People around here shaking their head, which is unsure as well. Alexei Magulov, no, he doesn't. 52.75. Still in third place, though. All to ride for here. The leader's out. Li Junkun is top of the chart. 87.75 is massive. We've seen the crippler, we've seen the back side air, the front side seven. Cab 7 and front side 9 as well. Throughout qualification, he was incredible. But he still needs to perform here because Nikita Taniev goes last and he didn't complete his first run. So no matter what happens here, Li Junkun will be top of the leaderboard in gold medal position at the end of this run. He goes massive with his first hit. Cripplers out. Second one's just a straight air before he starts spinning, and this is where he's comfortable. And he's gone for the double, and he's absolutely stomped it. That's the first time we've seen the double crippler. He's brought it out because he's got nothing to lose. He knows he's top of the leaderboard. No wonder he's pointing to the stars. Pressure on Russia. Pressure on Nikita of Taniev as well. Double crippler, welcome. Huge. Republic of Korea are looking to get their first gold medal in the halfpipe ever at this competition. Never have they got gold at a Universiad in the halfpipe. But there's one person who sits in between Li Junkun and gold. Unbelievable shots. He's going to improve his score, surely, the judges. The difficulty was more. He stopped it. 92.75! The pressure is on Russia now.
What point?
I didn't see it.
Nikita Avtaniev didn't land the first run.
Okay, you can go.
The Russian, who's many people's favorites for this competition, now has all the pressure on his shoulders because from the Republic of Korea, Lee Jong Kwon has just landed the first double of this competition. Nikita Avtaniyev, the 23-year-old, we've seen the frontside 10, we've seen a frontside 9 as well. Backside 5 is his best backside trick that we've seen throughout. He can do doubles as well, he can do a double cork 1080. But he has to make it count now. He goes huge, of course he does. 1080 first out as well. Double. Incredible stuff. Just has to see this out. The pressure is on the judges. The style is there, it's huge. He stomped a run. Sure there was a double cork in there. The replay will show us for sure. If he has landed the double cork 10. Going to be very close.
Perfect. Nice one.
Thank you.
Sportsmanship all around, holding the grab for a long, long time.
No, этот как дабл сделал, не знаю.
This one here, off axis, two rotations. Under pressure, he's absolutely throwing his best run down when he needed to. The whole crowd here, look on. All eyes are on the judges. He won 92.75 Russia. And their flags are flying. Who's won? Is it enough? Yes, it is! 95.50! Nikita Avtaniyev from Russia takes the gold. He went huge on his last run. For the men's results, Nikita Avtaniyev from Russia. It was dramatic, wasn't it? Takes the gold away from Lee Jong Kwon, who can be so proud of his silver. Axel Thelen takes the bronze. All of the finalists brought their best performances to the Sobka cluster this evening, that's for sure. We're going to leave you with a few shots of a fantastic competition, and we look forward to seeing you again at Krasnoyarsk 2019. But from us, that's all we've got time for. But thank you very, very much for joining us.